we had brief introduction about this queue earlier in the last lecture, when we have said that in case of stack there is only one end from where the data will be added or removed. But in case of queue, it will be considered as a pipe, so that one end will be used for the addition of the elements and the other end will be used for the removal. So we will be talking about two ends of the queue, namely the rear end and the front end. Okay, one end will be for the addition and the other end will be for the deletion of the elements. Of course, we can very well check if when you are going to implement queue using array, we can very well check as how many elements are there in the queue, but that cannot be the purpose. Okay, we will be using some array as a storage. That is what we call it as implementation of queue using array. And as in case of stack, I had drawn it as closed at one end, whereas we have said that we will be adding the elements from here. Actually, it is not that the element actually proceeds in this particular direction. You will be directly adding the element, but you will simply say that now there is one element in the stack. Now top is at position 1, now top is at position 2, like that. So though the pictorial representation could be the element is added like this, as I am showing over here. Similarly, in case of queue, though we say that one end is for the addition and the other end is for the deletion as such, we can have some intermediate situation like this, when few elements have been added. So front will point to the first element in that particular queue. Okay, that means the oldest element in that particular queue, because it is going to follow the principle called as first in, first out. Front points to the position of first element, first slash oldest element in queue, whereas rear is the position, or it will be the last filled position, as we have written it for the stack. So rear will be the last filled position and front is the position of the oldest element in that particular queue. So here this will be the element which has come before all other elements, that's why it has occupied a position over here. Then this was the next element which has reached, then this one, then this one, then this one. And then if we start processing, then we are going to remove this element and front will get incremented. Now the scope of the queue will be from this position till this. Logically, array is still the full one which we have allocated. Value which was there at position 0, which we have just deleted, that deletion happens to be the logical deletion, because physically the value will be still there. Only thing is, it is out of scope of the portion of that array which we are using as a queue. Okay, so physically the value is still present, logically it has been removed. The scope of the queue will be from position front till position rear. Whenever you add the element, obviously rear will proceed to the next position, even rear will be incremented. So for addition, you will have to increment rear and place the value. For deletion, you will have to remove the value from position front. You will have to remove the value from position front. So I am removing the value and then increment front, because that value is present at position front. So first you copy that value and then you increment front. So logically that position is out of scope. Got it? Value we will return back, as we were doing in case of stack. Similarly, before we actually store the value in that particular stack, in that particular queue, we will first increment rear So now rear will point to the next empty location and then we store that, because otherwise rear is pointing, rear is showing the position of the last location which is used for that queue. So you will have to first increment and then place the value. Here you will have to first pick up the value and then increment. Both of them are going to increment, get increment. Whereas in case of stack, for addition we were incrementing top, and for deletion after removing the value we were decrementing top. So yahan pe decrement kuch bhi nahi hota, both of them will get incremented. We have in all four logical operations. There are four logical operations which can be performed on queue, and those operations are to check whether queue is empty, to check whether queue is full, to add data, and to delete data. Four functions. The question will be, how are we going to indicate whether queue is empty or queue is full? Obviously, when rear reaches the last position of this array, for the placement of the next element, you will have to increment rear, which will go out of scope of that particular array. We will treat queue to be full. So for queue full, we may say that the condition will be rear equal to size minus 1, last location. So when rear reaches last position in that particular array, queue will be full. When will queue be empty? Rear equal to front will indicate that there is one value. See, when you say, one second, what he is saying is rear equal to front, then it could be position 4 where we have front as well as rear. What does it indicate? There is one element, so it is not empty. If we stick to our earlier case when top was set to minus 1, we can even say that based on the same concept, when rear is equal to minus 1, queue will be empty. So that when you place the first value, rear will be incremented, it will be 0. So at the beginning, what will happen when you place the first value? Rear was here, it is incremented, and now it is pointing to position 0. But as the case that he has pointed out, front equal to rear means one element, that means front should also be at position 0. We are putting the condition only on the rear. For queue to be empty, rear equal to minus 1. For queue to be full, rear equal to size minus 1. What about front? When we actually initialize the queue, like we did in case of stack, when the array has been declared and top was set to minus 1, we say that we have initialized the stack. Similarly, when we initialize queue, we will be setting rear to minus 1 and front should be set to 0. So that when rear is incremented for the first time, front is already 0, rear becomes 0, and front equal to rear will be the case, but at position 0 there is one element in the queue. Got it? So initially, that means when we start with this particular program, we say that initially front should be having value 0 and rear should be having value minus 1. That means it is the empty queue that we have. Got it? Make a note. Now when we talk about add queue, we will say that if queue is not full, क्योंकि क्यू फुल होगा तो वी कैन नॉट एड द वैल्यू. इन दैट केस इंक्रीमेंट रियर एंड प्लेस वैल्यू एट पोजिशन रियर. दैट इज वॉट द लॉजिक फॉर एड क्यू विल बी. एंड वेन वी गो फॉर डेल क्यू डिलीशन, then obviously I will have to check if queue is not empty. Remove value from position front and increment front. Is it okay with everyone? This is what we have stated logically. For deletion, front will get incremented. But then talk about the case which he has pointed out. Single element. Queue contains only one element. That means front is equal to rear. And if you perform this job, that is you remove the value at position front and increment front, then front will be incremented and it will go beyond rear. Now front going ahead of rear straight away indicates that queue is empty. That means we are required to put that check, because queue empty ke liye we are saying that rear should be minus 1. Whereas rear is not becoming minus 1 in that case. In case of stacks it was easy. Because when stack contains only one value, top will be at position 0. And when you remove that value, top gets decremented and it will become minus 1. That was our stack empty condition. But queue empty condition is not achieved when there is a single element and we call for del queue. That means after incrementing front, I will have to check if front becomes greater than rear. This is a special check that we have. When single element is there, then the status should be queue should be empty. And what is queue empty situation? Then rear should be, then reset value of rear to minus 1 and front to 0. That was our initial case. So this was the additional part which one has to remember. Otherwise yahan tak to sab kuch logical hai. Increment front, but we are talking about a special case when there is a single element, front has to be incremented, front will go beyond rear. Actually that there was single element in the queue which has been removed, queue will be empty now, but we are not reaching the queue empty condition that we have written, rear equal to minus 1, which we will have to explicitly state. We will have to reset rear to minus 1 and accordingly front to 0. Wo apne aap to nahi hoga. Got it? These two. Figure single element key you will have to draw. In the exam when they ask you some theory question, these type of figures should be self-explanatory. You will have to draw them. As I am talking about this case, it will be a corresponding figure which is drawn over here. Front and rear at some position and front gets ahead of rear. Q is empty. So reset. Without figure you cannot explain in that case. नहीं कैसे वेर रियर इज ऑलवेज पॉइंटिंग टू द लास्ट फील्ड पोजिशन. वेन रियर इज एट साइज माइनस वन पोजिशन क्यू विल बी फुल. वॉट इज द लास्ट पोजिशन इन द एरे? साइज माइनस वन. सो वेर डू यू हैव एक्स्ट्रा लोकेशन? इट इज द पोजिशन. So already size number of values are stored over. And as we write the functions corresponding to it, of course, in main, the declaration will go like int q square bracket size comma front equal to 0 comma rear equal to minus 1. That is the initialization whenever you start with any program of q. And the functions will be int qmt. We have already written the condition for it. It will be if rear is equal to minus 1, return 1, otherwise return 0. And as we require value of rear, qmt should be called with parameter rear. Actually is the same function as that of stack empty, and even qfull will appear to be the same one as stack full. When we go for add q function, the storage will be in the array, so we require array. It will be at the position. If you look at the algorithm that we have written, it is rear to be incremented, so I should know where is rear and the value to be placed. We will have to check if not q full. If q is not full, then increment rear and place the value at position rear. Will be the function add q. Now in case of function del q, we require that array because we will be removing the value from there. You can see it and then write. No, sat sat mat likho, kuch nahi hoga. We are going to remove the value from position front, so I will require front. But I am going to write a condition like if not qmt, but qmt is demanding for parameter as rear. एक्चुअली फ्रंट फंक्शन को रियर पास करने की जरूरत ही नहीं. दिस पर्टिकुलर डिलीट फंक्शन नीड नॉट बी पास्ड विथ वैल्यू रियर, क्योंकि इट्स जॉब इज टू इंक्रीमेंट फ्रंट. लेकिन जो कि हम यहां पे क्यू एम टी कंडीशन चेक कर रहे हैं विच इज रिक्वायरिंग वैल्यू ऑफ रियर, वी विल हैव टू पास इवन वैल्यू ऑफ रियर. सो इफ क्यू इज नॉट एम टी, remove the value from position front and then increment front. After this, if front goes ahead of rear, that means before incrementing front, front was equal to rear. In that case, front should be set to 0 and rear should be set to minus 1, and then you return val. Otherwise you can return 0 and stop. Got it? And again the same problem, as value of front and rear is changing inside the function, if you write functions in this form, it is not going to work. You will have to pass the addresses. So the call for add q should actually go like add q, q into bracket, q and rear val. This is how it should be called. And then rear should be a pointer. The same change that we have made, because the value is getting changed inside the function, it has to be reflected outside. Same is the case over here. Front is changing inside the function and sometimes even rear will change. So both of them should be passed as the addresses. Then it will work properly. No need to change those two functions, because over there as it is, rear is not getting changed. Okay? And this del q function will be called as some data equal to del q into bracket q comma and front comma and rear. Whatever I am putting it as comment is actually the manner in which it will be called from main. Got it? Make a note. Only the four functions which we will require for handling the queue. The thing that we should write in main, otherwise the menu will remain the same. To check whether queue is empty, queue full, add the value, delete the value, exit. In add value, you will have to accept the value and give a call. And in del, when he says delete, you will have to remove the value, accept that particular returned value, print it. Okay, remove data is fine. Why? Hello, एक सेकंड. What he is saying is, how can there be, I have drawn a figure like this. इसके लिए ना, actually it is not the value which is in between a queue, ऐसा नहीं है. Actually queue is only this much. It is in between array. Front to rear is queue, चाहे वो यहां हो यहां हो यहां हो, वही queue है. You are talking about ये ऐसे कैसे हो सकता है. See what happens is, suppose this is position 4, I might have added all the values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values I have added. Then the situation will be front at this position and rear over here. And then I remove. ऐसा तो होता नहीं है. See, the queue operation is simultaneous. As one person is buying the tickets, some few persons are getting added to the queue. Okay? When it is a picture like Munna Bhai and all. Whereas for other pictures, it could be other way around. That most of the times the queue is empty. As you enter the queue, you will be processed. Usme kya hota hai ke there the deletion rate will be faster. Now when deletion rate increments, front will be, this one element is deleted, second is deleted, third is deleted, fourth is deleted. So four elements are processed and front becomes over here. And during this processing time, no other element is added. So rear is still at that position. And when you process this element, queue gets empty.
I think it is the last element in the queue.
No, it is the first element in the queue. At that moment. At that moment. Jahan front hai, wohi first hai. Jahan rear hai, wo last hai. Haan. To wo last element bhi hai. तो ये सिचुएशन कहीं भी हो सकती है. let us see some situations when we are operating on the queue. First, a few elements are added, front remains at position 0, rear gets incremented to some position. Then some simultaneous additions and deletions, so few elements are deleted and few elements are added. Again few are added, some more are deleted, so the total number is reduced. Then few more are added and rear reaches size minus 1. This is queue full situation. Our condition is on rear, whereas this much of the memory is actually not used by the queue elements. We cannot reach this location at all because our condition is set on rear. Got the problem? It will be only the time when you delete all the elements, then both front and rear will be reset to 0 and minus 1 and you can again start using the elements from the first position. Otherwise every delete operation will result in reducing the memory by one position. And when number of add queue calls will be equal to number of del queue calls, at that time the queue will be set to empty situation and all the locations will be available for the data. Otherwise every del queue will reduce. Like when I am in this situation, there is no way that I can reach back to this locations. Nahi kar ja sakta. Okay, so this is what we consider it as a linear queue. In case of linear queue, this is a problem. Of course, the wording which we are going to use here for the next application, as it is called as circular queue using array. It is commonly known as circular queue using array. See the wording and see the concept first. What is happening is, as rear reaches this position, we can think of taking the rear to this position and start using this memory. In that case, I will treat this particular array to be folded like this, completely bent, so that the size minus 1 location is aligned to a position just before 0th. It is made circular so that when rear becomes size minus 1, you increment rear and it becomes 0 and you can straight away go on using it. This is a concept called as circular array. Physically it is not possible because memory is linear, so you will be always storing the elements one after the other. There is no way that after the last position you can have the first one. Aisa nahi hoga. But as a concept, this can be well accepted, that you can have the array in a circular manner. So you go on incrementing it and you can eventually reach back the first position, like your number system. It is circular. From 0 to 3 to 7, 6, 7, plus 1, minus 3 to 7, 6, 8, like that, plus 1 you can come back. Okay? Like that, it is circular, we say. Now, when we go for this circular nature, then I have an objection over here as the wording circular queue using array. Rather than that, it should have been queue using circular array. This will be more appropriate wording, but still in all the books you will find that it is circular queue using array, whereas it should be queue using circular array. वी आर नॉट स्टिल डेविएटिंग फ्रॉम द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ क्यू, वो तो वैसे ही रहेगा. सर्क्यूलर क्यू क्या होता है वो हम बाद में देखेंगे. ओके, सो वी आर गोइंग टू सी समथिंग लाइक दिस. दीज आर द प्रॉब्लम, दिस इज एक्चुअली द बेसिक प्रॉब्लम ऑफ लीनियर क्यू. नाउ इफ वी जस्ट लिस्ट आउट ऑल द फंक्शंस, लाइक आई विल कॉल इट एज सी क्यू एम टी. When will Q be empty? We can still continue using the same condition that rear equal to minus 1. Fine. For CQ full, we will talk about afterwards. Let us go for add CQ. It is just the extension of previous Q. Okay, just to eliminate that. So basic changes, that basic conditions will not change. Only thing is we will have to manipulate the position of rear after a particular situation. I am still to write Q full, but I will say that if not CQ full, then what should I do? I will have to increment rear. Q full nahi hai, iska matlab hai inme se koi bhi situation ho sakti hai. ये भी हो सकती है, तो भी रियर इंक्रीमेंट करके वैल्यू प्लेस करेंगे. रियर इंक्रीमेंट करके वैल्यू उसके बाद रियर जब साइज माइनस वन पे आता है तो रियर शुड बी सेट टू जीरो एंड प्लेस द वैल्यू एंड आफ्टर दैट कीप ऑन इंक्रीमेंटिंग रियर. सो रियर को सिर्फ एक बार स्पेशली हैंडल करना पड़ता है व्हेन रियर इज एट साइज माइनस वन. सो आई कैन से दैट इफ क्यू इज नॉट फुल देन चेक इफ रियर इज एट साइज माइनस वन देन सेट रियर टू जीरो. सो इट इज सर्क्यूलर. बाहर से देखते वक्त तो यह पता नहीं चलेगा अंदर हम क्या कर रहे, बट यूजर विल स्टिल गेट द सेम इफेक्ट. रियर हैज रीच साइज माइनस वन पोजिशन एंड देन रियर हैज बिकम जीरो एज इफ इट इज सर्क्यूलर है. अदरवाइज अगर वो साइज माइनस वन पोजिशन पे नहीं है एंड क्यू इज नॉट फुल, तो आप सीधा उसे इंक्रीमेंट कर दो. दैट इज अवर प्रीवियस केस. एल्स इंक्रीमेंट रियर एंड देन प्लेस वैल्यू एट रियर पोजिशन. इन केस ऑफ डिलीट क्यू, व्हेन वी थिंक ऑफ द लास्ट वन, दैट इज डेल सी क्यू, यू विल अगेन चेक इफ नॉट सी क्यू एम टी. अगर वो एम टी नहीं है तो यू विल फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल पिकअप द डेटा एट फ्रंट पोजिशन, नो चेंज इन दैट. देन देर इज अ केस इंक्रीमेंट फ्रंट. इंक्रीमेंट फ्रंट में कभी भी प्रॉब्लम नहीं आएगा एज लॉन्ग एज फ्रंट इज एनी वेयर एल्स. सी यहां कहीं भी फ्रंट हो Still there is no problem, क्योंकि front को increment किया जा सकता है. If the situation is still like this, which can happen now, ये front है, values add करते हुए हम end तक पहुंचे and then the next values are added from here, so rear will be at this position. ये हो सकता है जो कि पहले नहीं हो सकता था. इसमें भी फ्रंट इंक्रीमेंट ही होगा. यू रिमूव द वैल्यू एट पोजिशन फ्रंट एंड इंक्रीमेंट फ्रंट. इसका जो एक्सट्रीम केस आता है दैट वन हैज टू थिंक ऑफ एंड दैट सिचुएशन विल बी व्हेन फ्रंट इज एट द लास्ट पोजिशन अब जब फ्रंट इंक्रीमेंट होगा सो व्हेन फ्रंट इज एट साइज माइनस वन पोजिशन You remove the value from front position and reset front to zero. मतलब यहां भी जब आप increment front कह रहे हो तो वहां पे आप ये पहले चेक कर सकते हो. अ सिमिलर ब्लॉक सिर्फ आप पहले करोगे यहां पे कि इफ नॉट सी क्यू एम टी यू विल से वैल्यू विल बी द वैल्यू एट क्यू फ्रंट and then practically these four lines once again but written for front. If front is at size minus 1, then set front to 0. Otherwise, increment front and then return value. Okay? So, ye teen to aap likh lo and just tell me Q full. It is going to be extension of this. There are two cases when Q is full. When front is at 0th position and rear at size minus 1. Or the second situation could be we have added values, front is here. We keep on adding the values and every time after addition of values rear is incremented and it reaches a position just before front. Now definitely all the positions are occupied, Q is full. So there are two ways in which the Q can be full. Both of them should be incorporated in Q full. And Q full cannot be only written on the basis of rear, like rear at size minus 1. It will be front at 0, rear at size minus 1, it is full. Ya fir ye situation. So aap pehle 1, 2, 3 likho. Fir iske liye figures are essential. This case, front ko increment karne wala hum yahan pe likha rahe. रियर लास्ट पोजीशन से आगे लेके जाना, ओके? ओके, शुड वी राइट द फंक्शंस? CQMT will be based only on rear. Bravo. If the condition is true, it will return true, otherwise false. That means either a non-zero value or a zero value. Of course, if you are not comfortable, you can write it as if rear equal to minus 1, return 1, otherwise return 0. CQ full will require both front and rear because check is on both. So it is going to be int front int rear. First case, if front is equal to 0 and rear equal to size minus 1, return 1. This situation. Second, it will be if rear plus 1 is equal to front, return 1, otherwise return 0. And this time it is better to have the look as how we are declaring this Q in main. In main, I must have declared it as int CQ of some size. Front is equal to 0, rear equal to minus 1. Now, is there any problem? Is there any problem in what we have written up till now? ब्रैकेट्स नहीं लिखे इफ के. नहीं, एटलीस्ट मैंने तुम्हें जगह तो बता दी है कि कहां प्रॉब्लम है. प्रॉब्लम इज रादर लॉजिकल. लॉजिकली वी आर थ्रू with whatever we have, the figures that we have drawn, and we have reached the conclusion. What happens is, when we have set front to 0 and rear is minus 1, Q is already full, because this condition is not true, but this is still true. Or फिर आपका Q कभी empty नहीं होगा, it will be always full, so you cannot add any values, it will be a runtime problem. Though logically what we have discussed is correct, here we will have additional condition that and rear is not equal to minus 1. अगर rear minus 1 होगा तो ये condition का कोई मायने नहीं है, क्योंकि तब Q empty है. अगर ये add हमने नहीं किया तो इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल दैट यू कैन एड एनी वैल्यू, बिकॉज एड क्यू इज चेकिंग वेदर क्यू इज फुल एंड इट विल बी ऑलवेज फुल बिकॉज इनिशियलाइजेशन इज लाइक दैट. ओके, सो ये पार्ट काफी इंपॉर्टेंट होगा. ये अगर नहीं लिखा गया तो आप उसमें कोई वैल्यू एड नहीं कर सकोगे, एंड देर आर नो एरर्स ऑल्सो. इट्स अ कंप्लीटली एरर फ्री प्रोग्राम. इट इज रनिंग, यू से एड क्यू and then you say del q, it says that q is empty. चार values आपने add किए तो एक भी value q में नहीं आता. void add cq. we will require array and we are going to check for q full, and q full requires front and rear both. So you will require int front, int rear, as well as int val. You will be checking if not cq full, which is dependent on front as well as rear. In that case, if rear is equal to size minus 1, rear should be set to 0, else increment rear, and then place the value at position rear. With the same problem that rear is getting changed inside the function, all of them should be the pointers. Truly speaking, front pointer hona zaruri nahi hai, kyunki front sirf check ke liye use kiya hai, but to have the uniformity of parameters I am changing it to pointer. वैसे फ्रंट, अगर आप फ्रंट ही लिखते हो तो कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता इसमें, बिकॉज फ्रंट इज नॉट चेंजिंग विद इन द स्कोप ऑफ द फंक्शन. लेकिन फिर एक को पॉइंटर करना है, एक को नहीं करना है, तो फिर बाकी सब यूसेज में प्रॉब्लम होता है, याद रखना पड़ता है. इससे तो अच्छा है कि ब्लाइंडली अब फ्रंट एंड रियर जब भी पास करने हैं तो पॉइंटर से पास करो, टू एड एंड डिलीट, एंड फुल एंड एम्प्टी को वैल्यूज. del cq, it will be int cq, int, now I can write it star front and int star rear, int val. If not cq full, empty. If not cq empty, requires only rear, then value will be the value which is at front position, and then if अब जो कि हमने डिस्कशन में नहीं लिखा था अभी डेल क्यू में, मैंने सिर्फ फ्रंट को कैसे मॉडिफाई करना ये बोला था, लेकिन हमारा पहले वाला केस तो अब भी रहेगा. व्हेन फ्रंट इज इक्वल टू रियर, इट इज अ सिंगल वैल्यू विच गेट्स एलिमिनेटेड, फ्रंट शुड बी सेट टू 0 एंड रियर टू -1. वो तो करना ही पड़ेगा, लेकिन अगर ऐसा नहीं है तो फ्रंट कहां पे है उस पर डिपेंड करता है वेदर द फ्रंट शुड बी इंक्रीमेंटेड और इट शुड बी सेट टू जीरो. सो आई विल फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल चेक इफ स्टार फ्रंट इज इक्वल टू स्टार रियर. दैट मीन्स क्यू कंटेन्स ओनली वन वैल्यू. इन दैट केस फ्रंट शुड बी सेट टू जीरो एंड रियर इक्वल टू माइनस वन. एक्चुअली लास्ट केस में मैंने फ्रंट को इंक्रीमेंट करके फिर कंपेयर किया था. अब हम इंक्रीमेंट नहीं करते क्योंकि हमारे पास ऐसा भी सिचुएशन है जहां फ्रंट रियर के आगे हो सकता है. इसलिए फ्रंट ग्रेटर देन रियर ये सिचुएशन तो चेक करनी ही नहीं. फ्रंट इक्वल टू रियर इज सिंगल एलिमेंट एट दैट टाइम रीसेट. और अब जो मैं इंक्रीमेंट करने की बात कह रहा हूं उसमें आई कैन एक्चुअली राइट दीज फोर लाइन्स जैसे मैंने वहां भी कहा था. उसके बजाय मैथमेटिकली भी लिख सकते हो आप स्टार फ्रंट इक्वल टू स्टार फ्रंट प्लस वन परसेंट साइज. अब जब फ्रंट कहीं भी होगा यू इंक्रीमेंटेड बाय वन एंड टेक द रिमाइंडर बाय साइज इट विल बी दैट पोजिशन. सपोज साइज इज 10 एंड फ्रंट इज एट पोजिशन 4 सो फ्रंट विल बिकम 5. बट वेन फ्रंट इज एट पोजिशन 9 दैट मीन्स एट लास्ट पोजिशन फ्रंट प्लस वन विल बिकम 10. 10% 10 विल बी 0. यू वॉन्टेड टू सेट फ्रंट टू 0. एक्चुअली ये स्टेटमेंट आप यहां भी लिख सकते हो. चार लाइन क्यों लिखे हम. यू कैन से दैट स्टार रियर इक्वल टू स्टार रियर प्लस 1% साइज. इट विल टेक केयर ऑफ वेर एवर इज द पोजिशन ऑफ रियर. कहीं भी हो प्लस 1 करके परसेंट साइज किया तो इट विल गो ऑटोमेटिकली टू द पोजिशन एंड देन रिटर्न वैल. So there are two ways in which the thing can be written. Condition use करके लिखो या फिर बिना condition. You are checking the value of rather position of rear and then incrementing it or setting it to zero, or you use arithmetic operator percent and set it to proper position. Effect is same. If you have observed throughout this particular discussion, right from the functions of stack, I have never used something like star top plus, whereas I am explicitly writing it as star top equal to star top plus 1. Okay? Because it is the first question which is still unanswered, which I have asked you in string copy or string compare. Can you write star S1 plus plus? Kyunki uska answer jab tak nahi aata, this will be the safest way. क्योंकि फिर यही सवाल होगा कि वेदर प्लस प्लस हैज हायर प्रायोरिटी और स्टार हैज हायर प्रायोरिटी. हाँ आप ब्रैकेट्स डाल के लिखो इनटू ब्रैकेट स्टार टॉप ब्रैकेट कंप्लीट प्लस प्लस दैट इज वर्किंग फाइन. लेकिन कहीं अगर आप ब्रैकेट्स भूल गए तो फिर क्या होगा ये देखना चाहिए. उसमें प्लस प्लस की प्रायोरिटी हायर होगी तो पोजिशन विल बी इंक्रीमेंटेड एंड देन वैल्यू इज फेच्ड वेयर एज वी वॉन्ट टू इंक्रीमेंट द वैल्यू. Okay, इसलिए with the pointers one should be very cautious. If we really don't know it, in that case this is the simplest way. Don't go for plus plus operator. Say star top equal to star top plus 1. It will work properly. It is incrementing the value, not the position. Okay. And as I have said it last time, if the type changes, okay, circular queue, of float values, then you will have to simply change what? Iska type. Then, as I have shown you, this one. Body remains same. And in this case, this one, and this one. Body remaining the same. Array ka type badal do. Front, rear are still the positions, they will remain integers. Del Q ka return type change hoga. Kyunki nahi to log sabhi int ko float kar dete hai. That will be wrong. Aisa nahi hai. Sirf array type change karna hai, value ka type change karna hai, and del Q ka return type. Now before we stop today, two more functions are to be written which are not the logically correct operations on Q, and obviously that operation is print Q, because to satisfy our teachers and examiners, after every operation you will have to show the contents of Q. Okay, otherwise it is illogical operation. But we will require this function print Q, कि क्या है contents. और हमने पहले ही कहा था कि whenever you try to print, or printing is again a processing job, so you will have to remove the data and print it. So after printing operation Q will become empty. Okay, so अगर ठीक से वो function लिखना है तो आपको del Q को call करके print करते रहना पड़ेगा. Whereas here we are still storing the data and just printing the contents, which is logically not possible, but we will require this function. So it is going to be int Q, int front, int rear. It is int I, and I will say for I equal to front, I less than or equal to rear, I plus plus percent d q square bracket I, and one backslash n to go to the next line after printing. Front se rear position tak, whether the situation is like this, tabhi aap front se rear tak hi print karna chahoge. Whether the situation is like this, still you will be printing from front to rear. I am writing front print Q and not print CQ. Print CQ अलग होगा. This is our first four functions जो लिखे थे, उनके साथ वाला ये print Q है. और फिर CQ printing will be a different one. Print CQ. Now there are cases like these two. ये केस तो हो ही सकता है सर्कुलर में. Okay, so that loop will remain, but it is under the condition that if front is less than or equal to rear. If front is less than or equal to rear, front अगर rear से पहले है तो it is as good as linear. So in that case it is going to be for I equal to zero, for I equal to front, I less than or equal to rear, I plus plus CQ of I. Else, अब जो बात कर रहे हैं हम, that's a different story. It is going to be ऐसे होगा, फ्रंट यहां पे है और रियर यहां पे. लेकिन Q जब डिस्प्ले होगा तो ऐसे डिस्प्ले नहीं होता, इट विल बी स्टिल डिस्प्लेड लाइक फर्स्ट एलिमेंट, सेकंड एलिमेंट, थर्ड, फोर्थ, फिफ्थ, सिक्स, सेवंथ, एट्थ. सो स्क्रीन पे तो वही सीक्वेंस आना चाहिए. मतलब आई शुड प्रिंट फ्रॉम फ्रंट टू साइज माइनस वन पोजिशन एंड देन फ्रॉम जीरो टू रियर पोजिशन, ये सीक्वेंस प्रिंट होना चाहिए. सो एल्स इट विल बी फॉर I equal to front, I less than size, I plus plus, printf percent d CQ of I, will print that part. And then for I equal to 0, I less than or equal to rear, I plus plus, because rear is the last position. So, हमेशा लेस देन और इक्वल टू रियर आएगा. यू विल बी सेइंग प्रिंटेड परसेंट डी सी क्यू ऑफ आई. ओके, टू फंक्शंस विच आर जनरली नॉट सजेस्टेड अनलेस इट इज असाइनमेंट ऑफ स्टैक और क्यू. स्टैक का प्रिंटिंग आप कैसे लिखोगे? Not zero to top. Logically, it is top to zero. Printing का sequence will be the same sequence as if the elements are deleted. इसलिए stack print करते वक्त zero से top तक print नहीं होते, वो top to I greater than or equal to zero तक. Should not be written, no, actually. पुट अ मार्क के, दिस इज नॉट अ लॉजिकल ऑपरेशन, लेकिन फिर भी लिखने पड़ेंगे. इतना ही नहीं तो मेनू में भी लिखना पड़ेगा प्रिंट क्यू करके. बेस्ट वे इज मेनू में मत देना उसे, आफ्टर एवरी ऑपरेशन जो स्विच केस होगा आपका मेनू का, उसके बाद में हमेशा प्रिंट को कॉल कर दो एक ही बार. सो यू एड वैल्यू, इट विल बी प्रिंटेड, द एंटायर क्यू विल बी प्रिंटेड. You delete, entire queue will be printed. Like that. So, इसलिए मेनू में नहीं देते. After every operation, before you go to the menu, queue has to be displayed. क्योंकि वो actual choice देना भी गलत होगा. This is where our first application using array, first data structure will get over. Stacks and queues, both. In stacks, we have dealt with multiple, matlab two stacks to be handled using same functions, or two stacks to be handled using one array. Okay? And in queues, we have dealt with linear queue and, as is called normally, circular queue. But it is entire implementation is using array. We will be coming back to stacks and queues once again when we cover the portion related to linked list. And at that time we will again have a look as implementing stack using linked list, implementing queue using linked list. Okay? So linked list part is the one which we will be continuing from the next lecture. If any of other friends are still interested in joining, ask them to join from the next lecture. Like aaj jo join hue unko shayad pura pata nahi chala hoga, but again from the linked list part anybody can pick up what they have missed. We'll cover up later, kyunki ye fir se fir ek bar revise hoga hi linked list. But ek bar linked list shuru ho jayega to uske baad fir nobody can be joining any of the time. And then don't miss. इसके बाद अगर आपने मिस किया तो फिर गड़बड़ हो जाएगी. देन यू विल हैव टू नेसेसरीली अटेंड दैट लेक्चर, सी द सीडी बिफोर यू कम नेक्स्ट टाइम. नहीं तो फिर एक लेक्चर के बाद दूसरा, दूसरे के बाद तीसरा, कुछ भी समझ में नहीं आएगा क्योंकि फिर रिवाइज नहीं किया जाता.